We begin at 4 with a sex slave lawsuit. Lawyers claim several local hotels helped sex traffickers enslave young girls. Two of the hotels named in the lawsuit are on Roosevelt Boulevard in Philadelphia. A third is located on City Avenue. Joe Holden is live in Center City with all the details. Joe?
Well, in the lawsuit filed earlier today in county court seeks to hold responsible the owners, the managers, the parent companies of those three Philadelphia hotels. In the court document, it is alleged that sex trafficking rings were operating right under their noses. And it goes on to claim management and staff at those hotels failed to call police as sex traffickers were operating out of their facilities, using two young teens to facilitate their business enterprise. The three hotels named in the suit are Roosevelt Motor Inn and Days Inn, both on the boulevard, and North American Motor Inn at City and Belmont Avenues. Attorneys at Kline and Specter say the warning signs and key signature patterns of sex trafficking were ignored, those mainly being young women in their teens openly walking about the hotel in lingerie with a steady stream of men heading in and out of rooms.
The suit seeks now to hold the hotels accountable and the motels accountable for their failure to protect their patrons, these young girls, these victims, and to hold them civilly liable for what they've done. And to tell them that if you are going to make a living by renting rooms, by having guests at your hotel, you better make sure you know what's going on.
And we left messages for management of all of the hotels, including their parent companies. We also were outside the Days Inn on the boulevard. Their manager approached us.
Here's the heart of it. It says that failed to report to authorities that human sex trafficking was occurring at hotels.
Nobody informed us. No, we know. You are telling us, so that's why we came to know.
And the suit does not accuse these hotels, their parent companies, or management staff of having a hand in sex trafficking operations. Instead, again, the allegation here is that they did not call police. I'm back on Eyewitness News at 6 with more reaction as we try to nail down some comment from some of these hotels involved. I will see you then. We're live outside City Hall. Joe Holden, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
All right. Thank you, Joe.